Hey guys, how's it going? DUJ2 here, and welcome to another podcast. Now, I think this is podcast like number 20 or something like that. This is going to be a very different type of podcast. In this one, we're going to talk about a couple of things that have been happening in the game lately. And more to the point, this letter from the development team, I made an update video about this. Let's see. September 6th. So it was only yesterday. It was yesterday, one day. In one day, it's gotten over 4,000 views. And it's gotten like almost 100 comments on that video alone. And the comments, I mean, we were going to talk about this yesterday. But I started going through the comments and just reading what everyone was saying. And it kind of went from, you know, where's Proud Mode, because I thought Proud Mode was going to be here, and actually a correction, because they actually fixed it. It was no kidding, about half an hour after my video came out, that people started saying, oh, they changed it. And before, it didn't used to say this. It didn't say starting January 17th, and here it didn't say coming soon. It said Proud Mode is here. So we thought that, okay, so Proud Mode is here, but it wasn't. Anyway, we're going to talk about a lot of things. I'm going to open the floor to a lot of people, but I want to read a comment first that kind of struck me. This is from Oblivion239, and he's in the chat. He's in Discord right now. And if you guys notice, we have a cool little new Discord app. It doesn't include everyone, but I think people who talk show up top. I think. I don't know. We're going to see. Anyway, so Oblivion said this, and I'm going to read his whole rant, because it was quite a rant. I don't know if you saw my hour rant over on Discord once this notice came out, but if you didn't, I will repeat a shortened version of here. And if you don't know what he's talking about, on our Discord, Oblivion kind of did type a lot. This notice left me very mad at Square, because there was zero reason to even send out this notice to us. The news story part doesn't even matter to us right now, because we are about 100 quests behind Japan. Maybe even more so, telling us about the news story spot does not affect us at all. The multiplayer function is a cool thing for the future, but again, it was too early to tell us, and Proud Mode, like 90% of their player base, can't even do it because of how cheap they are giving us jewels. I also think Proud is coming in February 2017, not sure. And now, he said this before they changed it, before they fixed it. They should also change Proud Mode to be called Paid Player Mode, because that is the people who can do it. Japan, almost anyone can do Proud Mode, because they get thrown jewels at them left and right. My brother started playing the JP version recently, and he's being showered with jewels and free medals. This is the first month that they have been showing any love for their players, and we all know it's because the player count is dropping and they want the players, people to stay. All in all, they took one step forward with stacking medals in multiple keyblade layouts, which was very cool. But this update, in my honest opinion, is a giant leap back. The notice has nothing to do with us and just shows that they did it because they want people to stay. They could have easily sent this out when it was more relevant toward our current state of the game, but they didn't. And he says, you say, referring to me, you always say that our game is different. And yes, it is very different, but not in a good way. We got a higher tier guilt on some medals. Not a good for us, but good for them, because now we have to pull more because now the medal is more rare. We got guilting earlier, but getting to 300, 350, whichever it is in JP, isn't that hard. They treat us as if our game is on the same level as JP, but we are far from it. Rant over. I'm not happy with what they did. And then he did an edit. The rant was almost over, but I forgot to mention about the TVA medal and how people tried defending the medal that was easier for us to get because JP needed the medals gilted. They cherry-picked that part about the TVA medal for them. They left out the part that JP medals come orbed, and they usually get medals, jewels, to pull during it. To gilt the medals, you only need two of them. For us, we need to rely on either luck or having to actually pay for a medal. So there's another way we're being treated poorly, that even in JP, their medals come orbed and get jewels to pull, while we need to hoard them to be able to do a single pull. Last thing is the fact that they need to do 5 pulls for the medals from the banner, while we need to do 10. With our single guaranteed medal from the banner, they can get 2 and enough to gilt it, because yes, they do come orbed. Now the rant is over, just until they take another giant leap back. So that was not one of the most controversial comments, but it was one of the ones that struck me out the most. And just going through and reading, I mean, seriously, there's so many people commented about so much stuff in this one. And I think Oblivion is here. Are you here, man?
Yeah, I'm here.
You want to add anything else about this?
I've said pretty much what I wanted to say in that, but what Square needs to do is start caring more instead of caring. This is month five, right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, month five. We just, oh yeah, yeah, it's perfect. Today is actually the 5th month anniversary, guys.
Yeah, it took them 5 months to start giving us jewels, because I kept, like, over time, I did math. Mm-hmm. We were able to, the free-to-play players could pull a few times with our 3,000-something jewels a month.
Yes.
But Japan got around 10,000 a month, excluding all their free jewels. They just get thrown at them.
Mm-hmm.
So we can, now people are getting, we got the 500 jewels for 150. We got the 1,500 for their mess up, which was good on their part. And now they're just giving 600 jewels for getting to be able to guild. But again, it's really late that they're starting to give us jewels to pull.
Yeah, yeah. No, I do understand what you're saying. Yeah. Okay, so I'm opening it up. Anyone else in Discord right now want to say anything? Right now, we don't have chat on screen. It's pretty much just Discord. So anyone who's out there on Discord, you guys can just jump in and tell us who you are and then say whatever you need to say.
Hey, this is JM Krebs 30 here.
Hey, JM, how's it going?
It's going all right. I'm both happy and kind of disappointed about the announcement. We've got, I mean, it's nice to know that we've got Proud Mode coming, but at the same time, like what Oblivion said, we got that announcement a little early.
Yeah. What is it, February or January? So we're in what, September, October, November, December, January. So 4 months and 5 months from here. And you know they're not going to release it January 1st.
Oh, yeah, definitely not.
Which kind of makes you wonder why. I don't know. I just, it's a long time. I mean, okay, so why do you guys think they would do that? Why would they release something like it? It's twice the amount of time that the game has been out.
Hey, it's Lois Levis.
Hey, Miss Lois, how's it going?
Well, my theory is that this is a busy season for games. You're going to get a lot of new game releases. And they know that their veteran players are leaving. They may be getting new players, but mm-hmm. these new players probably aren't spending money. So they need to try to entice veteran players to stay around a little bit, if not now, but to just, you know, keep a heads up in January. Just don't delete your app and play it then.
That makes sense, yeah. It's huge, too. How big is the game now? Is it? It's up to like 1.2 gigs, 1.4 gigs,
something like that.
That's huge, and I mean, for most people, you kind of can't really have another game. So, what's stopping people from deleting the game now and then just logging in 5 months?
The jewels we'd get.
True, for logging in every day.
Zoom.
Hey man, yeah. What's up?
I like the idea they announced the multiplayer. Honestly, it's gonna be interesting, kind of how they're gonna work the concept in.
I wonder how they're gonna be able to coordinate that, though. I mean, because okay, this is something else. And personally, for me, I've never had a problem with this game. Never had a problem with this game. Since the last update, I have crashed consistently, like constantly, every single day. I constantly crash. I crashed during High Score Challenge this morning. And I know a lot of other people have been experiencing that too. And for me, the first thing that came to my mind when they said the multiplayer, I was like, how are they going to be able to support five people? Is it five people or three people?
I think they had five.
Five. How are they going to support five people doing the exact same thing at the exact same time and not letting it crash? You know what I mean?
Yeah.
That just to me seemed like a little, it's going to be a little difficult to do that. Okay, Discord's open, guys. You guys can say whatever you want. And I never do this. I never let Discord open like this. So you guys can, anyone, step up and say what you want.
Well, this is me again. Mm-hmm. But we're kind of playing Puzzle Monster Quest a lot, so I really could care less about what they have to say.
That is something to say. And yeah, we are going to talk about that too.
Hey guys, those, Mark,
yeah, go for it. Go, man.
I just want to say I love this game, you know, from beginning to end. But for the most part, I mean, I love how they're giving up the update, you know, during, you know, JP and stuff. But I agree with everybody. It's kind of a little early how, you know, it, you know, for some of the cool like features and stuff. But I mean.
Are you going to wait for that long for it? Do you see yourself playing for 5 more months?
I mean, yeah, I might play, you know, 5 more months, but until then, I probably might stop.
Jam again. I'm just going to keep playing this game until the story stops.
Hi, this is Nelson, and yeah, I agree with JM. I'm going to keep playing this game until it's over.
Do you see yourself playing every single day, hours a day, like we have been?
Even though, like Lois mentioned, this is Nelson again, I'm sorry, that we've been playing PMQ, I still play this game more than PMQ, whether we have more to do or not.
What do you find yourself doing?
Honestly, I farm material. I'm not a Lux farmer like some people, but I still collect materials. I still look. I also retry old challenges with different metals than I have to see how far I may have come in the game from when I started to where I am now.
Do you pay for
and
the
I'm
VIP
not a person
every week?
I spend a lot of money on this game. I don't. Okay. I've only bought the VIP 3 times.
Got you. And see, okay, since the that's something else. I mean, and I totally get you. Because someone in the chat right now, Proper Artist, who he's a really cool streamer too on Twitch. He says, as it stands now, I just log in to collect my jewels and SIDs and then play other stuff. And that actually kind of made me think of something. To collect daily jewels, you have to pay the VIP. My question is, for anyone here right now, is anyone planning to continue paying the $15 a week VIP just to log in and collect jewels and stuff?
No, not at all. No.
Have you guys been doing
it? Wasn't VIP, was it?
What?
No, was it?
No, the SIDs. Your daily SIDs, you know?
Yeah, I'm going to keep... Yeah, Jam here. I'm going to keep getting the SIDs on occasion.
So do you think you're going to continue paying $15 a week to keep playing?
Zoom here. Yeah, I can't keep affording to pay the 15, so I don't think I'm going to keep with going on with that concept of having to pay 15 every month.
Yeah, well, every week, dude. Because, okay, let's think of it this way. $15 four times a week, four times a month, times, what is it, 4 months? Let's say 5 months. 5 months. That's $300 more dollars. So if, and I'm not saying, I mean, I'm just saying the it's not even pay to win or the pay to, it's kind of pay to play. Because they're kind of saying, okay, if you're going to be logging into the game, then you might as well just be logging in and getting your SIDs as well. But if you just log in to just get your SIDs every single day until the new updates come out, that's $300 that you're going to be investing into this game. Is that something that people... And I'm just asking a question. I mean, because, okay, firstly for me, and this is why I'm kind of keeping myself not out of this conversation, but I am slightly removing my opinion personally because... As you guys know, as everyone knows, this is my job. YouTube is my job. Streaming is my job. This is what I do. If I don't make content, I don't have anything to show for it. I have nothing to make for it. You know, I have no videos. Like, if I don't have the content, I don't have the videos. So to me, when I look at this number, I look at it as from a point of, okay, am I going to make back this $300 in videos in over the next 5 months? And is it worth for me to continue playing this game? Now, yes, part of it for me is, do I enjoy playing the game? And I got to tell you, parts of it I do. And we're going to talk about high score challenges in a little bit. But like the Adamantite challenges, and a lot of challenges are very interesting to do. Today, I spent about 5 hours this morning, no kidding, trying to do the high score challenge. And I figured out a way to do it with the medals that I had to be able to get the maximum percentage that I have, which is 69%. I figured out a way to do it, and it took me, like you guys saw recently in that other video, I figured out a way to do it. It was just a matter of RNG and the skills activating over, you know, 30 something times of trying. So, but I actually figured out, and things like that to me are fun, but at the same time, I spent 5 hours that I could have been working on another game or making a video or doing something else. So for me, now I look back on it and I'm like, 5 hours wasn't really worth it. I spent way too much time doing something that I have nothing to show for apart from a score, you know. Anyway, who else had something to say?
Yeah, Snowman again.
Oblivion, what's up?
Honestly, I didn't like the concept of having to pay to do the high score challenge as well.
Yeah, go for it,
Tab medal, you have to pay to actually try and get that for Chance of Aqua. Because we just, what, recently got rid of quest medals out of the pools?
Yeah, this week. It was this week. You still there, man?
Yeah, I'm here.
Yeah, go for it.
But, lost train of thought.
It's cool. Anyone else want to say anything?
I just want to say that people would still buy the VIP for the discounted jewels also.
Oh, yeah, you're right. Okay, yeah, so you are getting, you are getting 3,000 jewels for that, I guess. Is it worth it, though? I mean, is this game worth another $300 for 5 more months?
Hi. Sorry if I'm interrupting.
No, go for it, Nelson.
So, the way I think about it, if I were someone who actually paid the $60 a month, if it's more in your country, it's more or less. But it would be, it depends how much time from a different perspective of, I'm not making money on off of this game, but I can either play this game if I enjoy it, or I can buy a brand new game for my console, my PC for the same price and play it for less time, since games are just getting shorter or don't have as much replayability.
Yeah, they are getting really short, aren't they?
So it's like, if I spend $60 on a game that only takes 9 hours to complete from start to finish, or I can play a game that's going to continuously get updates, whether we rage at it or are happy with it, it's kind of worth it from a gamer aspect, because it's because you're making back the money you spent on this game with the time you put into it. But that's my 2 cents on that.
No, it's a good one. It's a good one. I do appreciate that.
I'm sorry.
That. Yep.
You think $60 subscription is worth paying over a game that you've paid $60 just one time?
Sorry, are you asking me or Nelson?
Nelson.
Well, let me put it this way. I'm a console gamer primarily. I have a collection of games that half of them I'll replay, but the other half I have there and they've made no money back, and I finished them. I enjoyed the story, but right now it's like, if I replayed the game, I'd be like, I don't find the same entertainment anymore. So why did I pay the $60 for it?
Right. I'm also primarily a console player, and that's why I can't justify paying for this game.
Also, because the other thing is,
I get a full experience. I'm not waiting months on end to get story updates and, you know, pray for quest medals, you know, in my pulls.
Yeah.
Yeah, I gotcha. It also...
Oh, go ahead.
Oh, I was also going to say, it's also from probably, since it's honestly my personal opinion, obviously, but a lot of the games that have come out in recent years, I can honestly say, more than 60% of the games that have been released for PC or console, I haven't purchased or haven't had the desire to purchase because I just don't find them interesting. Watching someone else play it is much more interesting to me than buying a lot of the games that are out nowadays.
I'd have to agree with you on that one.
Well, and see here. Okay, here's something else. Something that just said. Okay. So just pulled and I. Maybe you guys know who O.O. is, but O.O. has been in the stream for a long time, and today was his very first time that he did 10 pulls. And I know he wasn't happy. You know, I know he wasn't happy with what he got. Has anyone here done the 10 pulls?
Yes.
Who is? Yes. Yes.
Okay, Miss Evie, how do you feel about it? Oh, wait, was that Miss Evie or someone else?
No, it was
Abby. Miss Abby, how's it going?
Hi, I'm Abby. Hi. Yeah, so I did the 10 pulls when Illustrated Sora came out.
Okay.
And I posted the pulls in here. So I think I said this before.
I remember. Yeah.
Yeah, so I pulled 10 times. Out of all the pulls, I only got 2 legendaries. I got a few epics, but I don't remember the exact number. But I just remember, like, I spent so much money just trying to, like, 10 pulls, like, I can get so much done. Like, I can get a lot of cool medals, and I would see people, and they get, like, 2-3 legendaries in one pull. Like, maybe that might be me. And then it just ended up, like, I get 2 legendaries out of 100 medals.
And that was still when the quest medals were in there, too, right?
Yes, it was. And luckily, I didn't get many quest medals from those pulls, but it was still, like, it was just so disheartening.
Well, when did you pull again?
I pulled Illustrated Sora and Riku came out.
Okay, so that was 4 weeks ago.
Yes.
Have you pulled any since then?
I still, like, pull from time to time, like.
But nothing huge like that.
No, I'm never doing a 10 pull ever again, because I know that, like, and also there's, like, the satisfaction in, like, when I would, I just did a few story quests the other day and I got 3,000 jewels. I pulled and I got the Illustrated Ventus. So it was like, it was more satisfying when I saved up the jewels and I pulled and, like, I got a legendary. That's cool. Instead of, like, pulling and pulling and pulling and not getting what you expect to get.
Right.
And just kind of being disappointed. It's just more satisfying, like, when you get something lucky in a pull like that than just, like, spending so much money at one time just to get, and just hopes to get more than the legendary medal that you want.
Right. And see, and that's the thing too. I mean, when you look at it from that point of view, I mean, not to say anything negative against people who do have legendary, gilded legendaries, but can you imagine how much it would cost to do that?
Like, even doing the 10 pulls is, like,
it's over $200.
Yes, it's $200. And, like, $200 is a lot of money for some people, especially
for anyone. It's huge.
Yes, exactly. Like, it's a lot of money, and to guilt legendaries, and just, unless you have insane luck, even when you have insane luck, it's still going to be more than $200, because there's no way that the game would be rigged where you would get, like, only doing 10 pulls and getting 7 legendaries. That just doesn't happen in this game, so.
No, I don't think anyone ever has. I don't think anyone ever has. It is definitely something we need to not only look at, but talk from the point of view of, you know, this is what's happening. I mean, this is what's happening in this game. And this game is odd in the sense that it allows you to see how much other people have spent as well. Because all you have to do is go into their medals pulled with jewels. And we need to realize that in this game we have... we've done the math. If you've been playing from the very first day, you have approximately there's almost 50,000 jewels in this game that you could have gotten free, you know. But you have to think, if you've bought all the avatar boards, if you've bought all that, I mean, that's a lot of jewels to be spent, which is a lot of money. And then I guess my main question is, do you feel it was worth it?
Hey, DJ, can you hear me?
Lou Flores, well, go ahead, man.
Hey, how's it going, man? I think it all depends on what your goal in the game is.
That's a good point. Yeah, go for it. Go.
If you're trying to be top, you know, 100, 200, even 500, you're going to have to spend money.
Yes.
A person like me, I've only bought 2 VIPs, and that was during Zero AP. but I've been free to play ever since the beginning.
Mm-hmm.
And I've been able to keep up with the game. I'm at level 220 something. I'm on quest 450. There's only three quests that I wasn't able to get all the Mickey heads on.
Wow.
The top three adamantite ore challenges on all of them, I've done at least three of them. So I'm missing like two or three on some of them. And that's just, but with free jewels. You know, my party is, we just ranked 75 last week. And we're all free to play except for one guy who's got some 100% BC Mickey, you know. So he's, nice. I don't know if he's a whale, but he's definitely, you know, he's definitely spending money. And we're having fun with it. Next week, we're going to try to get better than 75. So it really depends. Like, I love this game, and I think it's interesting to see you guys' point of view. But I've had fun with this game from the very beginning. I might spend $15 when I have it. If not, I won't get a legendary. You know, I'm not really worried about it that much as long as I can keep up with the game. And I think most free-to-play players, regardless of RNG, because if you see my polls, you can actually go on our Discord channel and see my polls. They're terrible. But I'm able to keep up, so I'm still having fun, and I'm going to continue to play this game until it sucks. And right now it doesn't. You know,
that's a great point of view. I love that because, yes, if you, and this is the thing. There's a lot of people who aren't free-to-play. There's tons of people who aren't free-to-play, and a lot of people who are here aren't. Look at our Discord. There's tons of people, and you know what? From what you're saying, I like what you're saying, but at the same time, you need to understand how a lot of people are actually going to be jealous of the fact that you haven't spent money, because they have, and they are not getting what they think they should be getting from the game. Now, this is my next point that I'm going to bring to you. Do you think that Square Enix is going to change things? Okay, let's put it this way. Do you feel, as a free-to-play player, that Square Enix cares about you and is taking care of you?
Not at all.
I'm talking to Lou.
I've always been a person that believes just in general that nobody owes me anything.
Perfect.
One thing that I've noticed when this game first came out is, like, in the very beginning, when you don't know what you're getting into, because I didn't know about the Japanese version, mm-hmm. I just knew that I loved the Kingdom Hearts series in general. They
yeah.
throw a lot at you. And I sold so many materials, and I didn't know what any of this stuff was. So they throw a lot at you. Now,
yes.
it gets
yes.
less relevant towards in the later stages of the game. But by then, I literally spent maybe two hours a day, if not more, playing this game. Like, it took up all my free time. When I was on my phone, I still have a life, but I spent a lot of time. So what I didn't spend in money, I spent in time in order to evolve myself as a player.
Gotcha.
And get this, and I watched your channel. Actually, this is my second attempt. I got up to level 300. I quit because I realized I wasn't guilting. I wasn't paying attention to a lot of stuff. So I restarted the game again, and I was willing to go through that. So yeah, I don't feel they owe me anything right now. They're giving me enough to keep me happy. I know I'm not going to be you or some of the other players that get all these fantastic medals, but I'm having fun with it. So
well, okay, see, this is my second question to you, from what I said. Okay, so yeah, you are actually having really great fun with the game. You've kept the game, you know, you've kept going with it. You've actually even reset the game, which is amazing. But do you feel that if everyone changed to your mentality, do you think Square Enix would change at all? Or do you think Square Enix is treating this game like a business more than a labor of love?
Well, it is a business. But look at the product they produced. I know you played a lot of other games, and I've played some. I'm not a real big gamer. I haven't had a system since the PS2,
mm-hmm.
And I'm not a real big mobile player, but it's a beautiful game. It works really well for the mobile platform.
It does, actually. It's very yeah. well defined, yeah.
Yeah, and it's beautiful. They are a business. At first I thought, because I don't know anything about, subscription games, but I was like, they had to have made enough money, because most console games are what, $60 not counting the online subscription or updates and all that. But I was like, they had to have made that money already. Why are they so greedy? But at the same time, I can't fault them. They're business,
yes.
Do I wish that it was $10 instead of $15 or $5 or something.
Oh, that'd be so great. Absolutely. But I wish it was $9.99 a month.
Yeah, like you see so many other games are 99 cents for this and that. And yeah, I mean, it could be cheaper. Yeah. But at the same time, I've survived in this game for free. So no, I mean, if I can't pull one week, then so be it. I don't pull. I'm still going to go back to this game and try to find something else to do in the game to keep me busy.
Right. I love that. I thank you very much. I really, really do love the fact that you're not salty at the game because you've been able to do what you can do with, I'm not going to say a minimum because it's not a minimum, but you've done what you've done. Now, my next thing is, okay, do we have anyone in Discord right now who has bought the VIP every single week?
I have, yes.
Okay,
Cryo. Since the beginning?
Okay. Yeah, since the very beginning. Like, since day one.
Yeah, I've been playing the game ever since about the first week or maybe second week.
Okay.
I bought it every time because I think that...
Okay, my very first question is, okay, and I'll tell you this, guys. I've bought the VIP for every week except one. That one week when I was kind of like, I wasn't happy. But, okay, you've bought the VIP every single week. Now, what's your main reason for buying the VIP every week?
My main reason is that I believe it is generally the best deal in this entire game because for the price of what's normally 1,700 jewels, you're getting about twice that for ponying up $15 a week. And for my job right now and for the amount of time I spend on it, I think that let's say you buy it every week for a month, that's 12,000 jewels and you can do a lot with that.
Yes. Yes, you can. I like that a lot. Now, has there been any week that you're like, oh, you know what? I don't think it's worth it this week.
I don't think so because with those 3,000 jewels, if you don't get it for a week and something comes up big, like a new EMC that you want to get the medal for, then you're going to have to spend up more money on, you know, you get a better rate of jewels for getting that VIP than you would just by saying, okay, so if you buy $15 worth of jewels, like normally it'd be, you know, 1,700. So getting 3,000 for that same price, I think it's pretty much worth it.
I like that. Okay, so how do you feel about them releasing, saying these updates are going to be coming out in another 5 months?
It's rather weird. On one hand, I'm thankful that 5 months in, they're starting to be a little honest with us, saying that, okay, guys.
Yes.
Later down the line, we're going to have a bunch of this cool stuff, and it's going to be really awesome. We hope that you guys enjoy it. I don't mind it too much because I've been a console gamer all my life. I'm used to having games be announced like a year or two in advance, and with Square, that tends to be a pretty common thing. So I especially don't mind it because we have Kingdom Hearts 2.8 coming out in, what is it, December? So that's going to give us at least a little bit of leeway between now and then, not too much, but people got to understand that there's still going to be a lot of content in this game in that meantime.
Right.
It's just not going to be in the story quest area.
So do you feel that... Okay, and not to pry too much, but have you bought jewels apart from the VIP or have you just stuck to the VIP?
Not too much, really. It just depends on what the weekly deal is. Like, is there an orbed week or... Okay, so this week would be the prime example. I held off on the EMC for the longest time because I really, really wanted to get Belle and a Gilded Belle at that.
Oh, she's...
So,
did you get her?
Yes, I did, actually.
Congratulations. She's amazing.
She really
that
is.
That AoE Alice is the greatest thing in the world.
Yeah, and going into this game, like in the future, that medal is going to be very crucial. And if people don't get one while it's, you know, probably guaranteed, I think they're going to be missing out later.
Yeah, because if you do three pulls, you're kind of guaranteed at least one. Just because of how the algorithms work, you know? And yeah, and if you're lucky and that's the one you're going to get a lot of, you know, yeah.
Okay. By the way, my results.
Just to ask you something real quick.
Yeah.
Chats are kind of going crazy. And are you single?
I am single, yes.
Okay. So everyone in chat.
He's mine. He's mine. Okay.
I'm already taking
medicine. I call
people
him.
Like okay. You a lot. They want you, man. They want you. All right. Sorry. Keep going. What'd you say?
Okay. Well, I was going to say that. Okay. So I had some extra jewels, but I did spend $200 to do the pulls for the CMC because of the Beating the Beast medals.
Gotcha.
And in those 10 pulls for Aqua, it wasn't really that good. I had a few like surprises, like I got a Black Coat King Mickey. I got a lot. I got more Cogsworth than Bells, to be honest. But
really,
yeah. But
how many did you get?
That,
how many legendaries did you get?
I got zero legendaries out of all of those. But
you got the guaranteed Aqua.
But besides the Aqua,
gotcha.
Yes.
Wow. See, I was really thinking that maybe the luck had changed and they or the RNG had changed and they were giving more legendaries, but they're still not. Wow.
Well, it sort of did, because the thing was that I had enough jewels for 3 extra pulls,
okay.
And against my better judgment, I did. And in those 3 pulls, I got the 3 bells I need to gild her,
wow.
At the very end, I got a HD Axel.
Nice.
So it, and I hate to say that those last 3 pulls kind of made up for it, but it sort of did. It's just really, really up to your luck. And if you don't have it, this game can torture you for it.
Yes. And then you can look back and be like, this is totally not worth it. You can just,
yes,
and that's, I have to say this. I mean, that's what I see. I see that a lot in our Discord. I see a lot of people who are like, here we go. Wish me good luck. I'm going to do 10 pulls. And then after, they are hating themselves for doing it because they didn't. I guess you have this hope that you're going to get something great. And then you don't.
Well, you should.
Yeah. Yeah, you're right. Yeah. But don't you feel okay? And this is my other question, especially with this game and with any game. I mean, I feel like it should be a very fine line. And again, not okay. I'm going to bring up PMQ again. And I don't know if you guys have played it or you haven't, but a lot of times, like when you spend money in a game or you do something, it's not that they should make you feel good for spending money. But it's really nice when after you have, you're like, oh my goodness, I'm so happy.
It should feel worth it.
Yeah. Oh, hey, Miss Evie, how's it going? Okay, Miss Evie, can you please, have you been listening?
Yes, I have.
Okay, can you, first of all, let us know what you feel about the update of the future update.
I think it's ridiculous, and we would have been fine without knowing about it if it's going to happen all the way. I mean, why do it now? Why tell us now when it's irrelevant? I mean, we've played for hundreds of days without really knowing anything of an update coming. They just threw it at us. So now all of a sudden you're nice enough to tell us that, hey, months from now you're gonna get this, so stick around. Okay,
did you like it? I mean,
no, it pissed me off. I mean, everybody knows who's on stream that I am like pretty much over it. I'm done, and everybody knows that I've spent quite a bit on this game, and I just don't, I don't feel the enjoyment anymore. It doesn't feel worth it anymore. Like you said, after a pull, it's like, I could have used for that for something else, or it wasn't worth it. And it's great for like people who I applaud them, who are free to play and can be happy with the game. But like for when you spend a certain amount and you're still not advancing as you think you should, it's just like, really, then it's just like going to waste. Why am I doing this? It's just, it makes no sense. It's like you said, in PMQ, I feel like you get rewarded for the time that you spend on the game. You go into these quests and you can grind them. And
it's kind of crazy, isn't it?
Yeah, you pull, and it's like, I know we have the whole friends points thingy, and it's not totally the same as the crystals thing.
Yeah,
because you do get some of the quest things, but you still get something back. I feel like you get rewarded
for playing the game, and the more you play, you can still advance perfectly fine. There's many of people in PMQ who are free to play, and they're advancing more than me.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. Way beyond me. Yeah. There's people that I look and I'm like, how do you have these things? And then I find out that the monsters that they have are free, are in the quest monsters.
Exactly.
And you can get them like 20 quests ahead of where I am.
Amazing things by just playing the game. And yeah, Kingdom Hearts gives you the same thing, but I don't think it's enough. And I don't want to sound stingy or any kind of thing like that. It's just, I feel like there should be an option to be a free-to-play player and like still advance as much as a person that pays,
right?
Or and if you pay, like, it's just, you know, I'm just, yeah, I'm kind of over it.
did you hear what Lou said?
Which one was that one?
Lou Flores.
Okay,
let me ask you something, because I felt this way. Did you, when hearing him, did you feel like you wish you had gone free to play?
Absolutely.
I totally did. I'm not going to lie to you guys. Hearing Lou, what he said and what he's been able to do, I was sitting here thinking, why didn't I do that? I mean,
the moment he said he restarted his game, I was like, oh my God, I could never do that. Because my account has so much. I don't have that freedom. So I was like, you know what? I don't like the progress of this certain account. Let me just start over. I can't do that, because obviously there's like so much into that.
But
account.
Wouldn't it be
Even
so
now,
nice if you
I feel
could?
Obligated to play. Yeah, absolutely.
I totally agree with that. And definitely healing me, Lou. And I'm really glad Lou talked. I'm very glad Lou talked, because I got to tell you guys, hearing his, what he's done and how he's done it, it saddens me to admit that I wish I would have gone free to play in this game now.
Hey, DJ, it's Lou here.
Hey, man, what's up?
I emailed you probably 2 or 3 weeks ago all my stats that broke down everything that I was able to
do. Oh, yeah, I remember that.
So, yeah, that shows you everything there. And I don't have any powerful metals or anything like that, but I was still able to do that. And I was actually going to ask you when Evie started speaking, like, would you feel as salty if you hadn't spent that money? Like,
well,
no.
Sorry, okay. So for me, and I think I'm here. I'm hearing you. Okay, thanks. For me personally, I don't, because like I said again, I'm in a slightly different position. Yes, I have spent a very large amount of my own money, and I have spent a lot of money in this game too, because people have donated. And let's put it this way. For the amount of money that I've put into this game from donations and from my own money, I should be this close to a legendary gilded medal, because that's how much most people have. My luck is not good. I am not lucky, guys. I am not lucky at all. Even in PMQ, I'm realizing that now. I have pulled a lot more than most people. And again, that is because Kick9 is sponsoring me in that game, which does give me the capacity to pull way more than most people do. I've gotten, what, three rainbow eggs, four rainbow eggs, I think, in like 7 pulls, 8 pulls. So, and that's 80 monsters pulled. And I've gotten like 3 or 4 rainbow eggs. So just looking at it overhead, I have spent, my luck is not good. And then you look at this game and look at the medals I have. And yes, I have a lot of medals. But for someone who spent the amount of money, and I mean, Square Enix doesn't know people, you know, people donate or not. And I will say this, because people are always asking, I don't know exactly. Okay, I do know. Okay, let's put it this way. Out of my own personal money, not donations, out of my own personal money, I have spent 4 digits in money, okay? So that just tells you right there, okay? And then on top of that, everything else that everyone has donated. I spent a lot of money in this game, guys. A lot of money. And if you look at what I have to show for it as a game and as medals, yes, I have a couple of legendary medals. How long did it take me to get Pooglet? I mean, seriously, how long did it take me to get Pooglet? And then if you look at the fact that I own, where is it? I have three gilded Dumbos, and one Dumbo this one Dumbo, one of these Dumbos, got rerolled 7 times, okay? So we're talking about the fact that I have over 30, I've gotten over 30 Dumbos in this game, not to count all the other medals. So if you just look at it from that point of view and look at how what I've done, and I know, Lou, you said, am I salty about it? I'm not really salty about it because it's a game, you know? And we've had fun with it, guys. We've had fun with it. I mean, the whole Square Enix button guy, and now there's a button guy over on PMQ as well. For me personally, it gives me a sense of, I like doing it to be able to show you guys what the lower spectrum of RNG is, what the lower spectrum of luck is. I want you guys to see it. I want you guys to see what this game can offer people who don't have a lot of luck. And then we do see people who keep pulling, you know, legendary every single pull and a bunch of really great pulls. And it's great. I love it. I love that. But I will honestly say, after hearing what Lou said and how he said it, I honestly, it would be great to be free to play. To that point, it would be great to think I've only bought VIP a couple of times, you know. Oh, that's another thing I was gonna say. Lou, have you done any high score challenges?
I have.
Have you gotten any?
Is 450 something.
Are you in this one right now?
Yeah, I think that's where I've gotten the 450. Let me look.
Wow, that's really good. That's
good. Yeah, but you gotta remember too, it's from watching your videos, it's from the comments that you're that everybody on Discord makes.
Yeah, there is a lot. There is a lot of strategy that people give on Discord. Yeah.
You know, the poison sleep technique, or not sleep, but a paralysis technique. I mean, I literally through this one, the score is 423,665, and I tapped my way all the way through it with paralysis and poison, and I just couldn't beat the cannon.
Oh, gotcha. Yeah, the cannon. He's a little bit of a. Whoa, really? And you've gotten that high without beating Cannon.
Without beating Cannon, and it kills me. And I guess SE is now allowing you to keep your score, so that's pretty awesome.
Yeah. Wow! Yeah, if you beat Cannon, that would be another through, what? And then 80,000.
Yeah, he raises his attack boost to 3, and then he one turn.
Man, you can do that as a free to play. That's just.
Yeah, and those are just like the other day I wanted to comment when you made that video and you wouldn't stop until you made your technique work.
Oh yeah, yeah.
Remember what was your bonus?
My bonus was 31%.
Did you have the knockback or someone in your party had it?
Yeah, no, somebody had the one that gives you the 10, because I had enough for 20, mm-hmm. 21, and then I used somebody else's that had 10. But you made that video and some of the higher ranked players were like, just you have stronger medals, just do it another way. But I was cheering you on because that's the way a free to play player would have to have done it. They would have found a system like, okay, this attack boost works, this is going to work. And you kept doing it. And that's what we have to do. We have to just keep grinding, and then we run out of AP, and we have to wait till the next day and we do it again until it works. And it makes it more satisfying. So,
I felt pretty awesome that day when we finally did it.
Yeah, and it's like you're talking about the money. Money creates expectations. So if you spend money, you're gonna expect better pulls. But when I pull, I don't spend money. So anything that I get, like I didn't have a healer for a long time, and I've been wanting Mei forever. When I finally pulled her, maybe last month, I mean, I was so overjoyed, and she's Bay now because I don't have the money to just pull every week and see if I get her, you know. So when you finally get those good medals, it feels even more awesome. So yes, like you're saying, I wish it for you that you could go back and do it as a free-to-play player, because I think you would have way more fun.
I think it'd be interesting. I really do think it would be really interesting.
In this point, I'm glad I don't have a credit card.
Okay, anyone else want to say anything before we end this one?
Crow 94 here again.
Hey.
Hey, I will say that when I said that I did the whole Epic Metal Carnival tentpole thing, that was probably the most I've ever spent on this game. But mm-hmm. the good thing about doing all of that and it being in concurrence with quest medals being dropped mm-hmm. is that, speaking of somebody who had stacked medals in like different keyblades, like say my power keyblade would be pretty good, but my magic keyblade would be pretty underwhelming.
Mm-hmm.
This was a great way of taking the time to build up my squad and now having a good enough array to go into, you know, the next couple months having a good enough keyblade for any occasion to take on whatever Square throws our way.
Gotcha. Do you feel that you're going to continue doing the VIP?
I would say so, yeah, because I think that you can do so much more. Like, that extra 1,300 jewels you get from the VIP, like, not only... I haven't even talked about the benefits. I mean, you know, having VIP, that having all those missions, like, there for you to do on your own time, not having to wait for a specific day,
mm-hmm.
That helps out a lot. You don't have to go through everyday timing, like, okay, I'm going to do this on this day.
Right. Yeah, that makes sense. Yeah. I remember I think I've done 2 weeks without VIP, and it was so weird not being able to be like, okay, you know what? I need to guild this medal, or I need to take this one to 6 stars, 100 over 100. Okay, let me just do it right now, you know? And then it was like, yeah. Oh, I can't, because I have to wait till Thursday. And then I have to wait till the weekend to be able to get enough Mickeys to do it. Yeah, that was definitely difficult.
But you're feeling that now on the other game.
True. But in the other game, I can just do Titan all day long.
You're not always going to have it, though.
Very true.
Yeah.
But then he can farm monsters.
Finally.
In the
yes,
dungeon.
I can finally farm. Oh, okay. And that's something else I'm going to say, because I don't want to talk too much about PMQ. But of course, I have to talk about PMQ. Come on. PMQ is awesome. PMQ is amazing. Yes. It can, yeah. But I will say this, something that I really, really like about PMQ is that they're not making the weapons something that you have to spend money to get. You know, it's like, it's not impulse. Like, there's not a weapon and armor summon statue. You know what I mean? Because if there was that, I think I'd have a little bit of a problem. The fact that you can just get incredible weapons and armor just from grinding the stages... has anyone reached the max level yet?
What is the max level?
Well, no, max level. I think Puzzle Boss is up to 107, 108.
Mm-hmm.
His combat level.
114.
Okay, wow, he jumped that much in one day. What about like actual zones?
It goes past. I've gotten maximum to zone 25.
But is there more after that?
I don't know, because
you can't beat it.
So difficult, I can't beat them right
gotcha.
Now.
So see,
I think Ricky says she knows somebody that's in the 30s.
Okay, so see, and that's the thing. There are levels that we don't even know about yet, but they totally exist. Which, to me, the fact that that's pretty cool. I mean, to me, it's awesome. It's awesome the fact that this game, the PMQ, rewards you for. Just for playing it.
Yeah.
Which is, awesome. It's weird. It's almost, and it's something that, I mean, something that we had talked about the other day in the stream about KHUX and saying how it would be amazing if, like, you did Ava and defeating Ava, even if you did it, you know, 100 times, but in that 100 times, there was a 1 in 100 chance that you could get an epic medal, you know, or or that you could get something, if there was some sort of a reward system that just rewarded you for playing. And yes, I know people are gonna say, well, that's the daily jewels, logins and everything, you know. And yeah, it is. And also the Lux, I get it. You go crazy on Lux and you can get, well, you can't really get, well, what do we get for getting high on Lux every week?
Nothing. You just get an ego boost for being high rank.
You get extra. Yeah, you get extra, sometimes chips and Dale, sometimes Sid. For me, getting high in Lux, it equates to I can unlock more parts of Avatar boards.
Mm.
Because your party being in the top, I think it's 100, you get 100 extra Avatar coins.
Right.
Instead of having to potentially farm money and quest medals to get them fully orbed to sell to get like one or two.
Right.
And personal scores, being in the top 25, gets you an extra 30 or maybe extra costumes and stuff like that. I'm not going to sit here and lie to everyone and say that that's what makes, you know, farming Lux worth it. But to me, it makes me a little happy being like, okay, doing my best, whether I spend money or not. And I've spent more than Lou, but I've spent less than probably most people that aren't free to play.
Right. Well, then the other question would be, if there were some seriously awesome rewards in the top Lux rankings, would it turn into a high score challenge thing? Because like right now, okay, this is the last point we're going to talk about right now, but the high score challenge. Is anyone in the top 200 or a top 1,000? Okay, this is the thing. It's impossible to get there without spending money. I mean, it really is impossible now. This time, they took away all of the weird little things they had, and it is completely impossible now to get in the top 200 or 1,000 without spending money.
Not to mention luck to do.
Not to mention what?
Need insane luck. RNG.
Oh, yeah, true. Yeah. No, but I'm saying, even if you had that, I mean, there is no way. There is no way of getting... Okay, let's look here. As you guys know, sometimes the top 10 have been people... Wait, is there someone there who's 300? Oh my goodness, there's two people who are already level 300. How? Okay, well, congratulations to those people at 300. There have been several times in the past, in other high score challenges, there are people who are free to play in the top... Well, the accounts are free to play, you know? And I'm not going to put people on blast here. I'm not going to go through each individual person and check to see how many jewels they've pulled. We'll do that off the video. But I'm guaranteeing there's no one here with under 100 metal pulled medals. You know? So would the entire game turn like that if next week they release, I don't know, exclusive medals or Mickeys and Brooms or something like that, or free epic medals or something like that in the top 10 or top 100 for Lux rankings?
Well, they kind of had something like that when they gave us that special title for being in the
top
50 or something.
Well, but does the title give you anything?
No, and the competition was so fierce just for that.
Can you imagine what it would be like if it was like a free legendary?
Oh God,
that would be ferocious.
Okay, let's honestly think of it this way: the way this game is set up, wouldn't it be perfect if, like, last week, knowing that this week is you know, this high score challenge, if last week it would have been a free aqua, illustrated aqua, for like the top 10 people or the top 100 people or the top 200 people in Lux rankings? What would that do?
People would have raged.
Well, but think about it. That would be, it would make perfect sense for a game to do that, because then people would have gone crazy playing and Lux like crazy and going, yeah, like one free aqua, like a free illustrated aqua to the top 200 Lux people. Because then you could say it's open to everyone. You know, you don't have to have great medals to do that. You can just, you know, grind Lux like crazy, and you can be number in the top 200.
Yeah, I have to agree with you. That would be a good idea.
But then again, then you would have to also argue the fact that eventually AP runs out. No, unless it was like the weekend raid bosses, you know? Or if the week... Okay, if weekend raid bosses, part of their reward was one free legendary medal that was going to help you in the next high score challenge.
That'd be reasonable.
Would it still be fair?
Sure. It'd be available to everybody.
I think if you kept it more open and say...
But it wouldn't fit... Everyone... Sorry for cutting anyone off. Anyone could get it, and it would be good for people who might not care about the high score challenge, or people who are like, yay, I can get a medal to progress in the game or do other things. And it would also be good because it wouldn't, I guess, make less of the people who actually spend a lot of money on this game to do as well as they do.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, if anybody tried to get that medal or would want to try to get that medal, I think it'd probably be the people who are spending thousands of dollars on this game. If you made it, say, like, top... You kept it open, say, like, top 1,000 people get a medal. I know that's kind of a big number for it, but I think a lot of people would then be interested, saying, oh, dang, I don't have the, like, the time or the medals to get 200. There's no way I'm going to be able to do that.
Right.
But if you kept it, like, fairly reasonable and gave them a good reward for it, then, yeah, like, people would go, like, they'd go crazy about it.
Hmm.
I can tell you guys, this is Lou again, I'm looking at my best solo ranking for Lux, and it's 318. And I'm in Vulpes. So, I mean, and that was, I think, when they first started the weekend raid bosses.
Right.
And I was able to get that high. So it's possible.
Interesting. I do like it, man. Guys, I like the conversation of this kind of stuff. But anyway, okay, to wrap it up, again, does anyone have anything they'd like to get off their chest or anything anyone wants to say before we end this?
Just a comment.
Go for it.
Luck.
Flame Salvo, yeah, go for it.
Good idea. Because that way, what circumstances?
I think you're cutting in and out a little bit. Can you talk directly into the microphone?
Yeah.
Go for it.
So, be your AP, because that way, no matter what circumstance,
you're still cutting.
Yeah, sorry, man. I think
it's the connection.
You might want to try and get a better connection and try again a little bit, okay? All right, let's give someone else. Anyone else who would like to say something before we end this one?
Yes. There's something about the Epic Metal Carnivals that I would like to say.
Go for it.
They should definitely lower the number of times you have to pull to get a guaranteed legendary.
Yes.
I'd agree with that.
Why do you say that?
$100.
It's a lot of money. It's a lot of money. It's okay.
It would still be a lot regardless. But
yes, and
they should definitely.
Let me put it this way. Because I know there's a lot of people who are free to play, and I know there's going to be a lot of comments that are going to be like, "Well, haha, you spent that money, whatever." And I get it. That's fine. And let me put it this way: you're not going to understand how just it's like a kick in the gut. After you do the 10 pulls and you look back, you've pulled them, you've done them, and then you go look to your medals and you just sit there with this feeling of where's my money? It's a very, it's not even depressing. It's just, and I'm sure all the people here know what I'm talking about. It's a feeling that, okay, maybe someone with gigantically good RNG would be really happy and bouncing off the walls after doing it. I've never felt that way. I've never felt that way at all with any of the pulls I've ever done in KHUX.
I honestly, yes. I felt happier when I would just randomly pull, when I would just save up gems and then, or sorry, jewels. Mm-hmm. When I would save up jewels, and then I'd pull, and then I'd get something good or something that I needed, rather than doing the 10 pull thing that
yes.
I did.
Oh, you know, and that's perfect what you just said, something that was needed. And I Am the Gal just said something too. I felt amazing that one time that I did the 7 pulls for the, well, not amazing, but I felt good when I did the pulls for the BC Mickey, the guaranteed BC Mickey, because I knew I was going to guilt him. I knew he was an amazing metal. I did get an absolutely horrible guilt the first time. And believe it or not, pretty much every single mirror that I've ever gotten from this game has gone to the BC Mickey to try and get him up, because I know he's awesome. The sad part is that we're progressing in the game to a point where he's kind of not becoming so awesome anymore. He's still great, but a lot, if you guys have noticed, a lot of the quests that we're doing and everything, they're not made for the Olympia Blade anymore. I mean, I pretty much just use Divine and Starlight now. I don't even use Olympia that much anymore. Yeah, I understand. I understand what you say. Yeah, I understand. Anyway, anything else? Anyone else want to say?
What topics are on the table, if I can ask?
Anything right now. You can say absolutely anything you want about the game.
Thank you for playing Kingdom Hearts Unchained.
That's what Square would like to say.
Yes, that is what they would like to say. Yeah, right now we're pretty much talking about how the high score challenge makes people feel, how this this weird update that was just like, hey, you know what? It is kind of very suiting because today is the 5-month anniversary of the game. And to be told something that's going to happen 5 months in the future, I mean, to me personally, it's like what Miss Evie said. I completely 100% agree with what she said and what Oblivion said too. It's like, okay, and? I mean, I did reading that. I felt like, okay, great. We're going to get these updates next month. And then I was like, oh, wait. We're getting them in January of next year, February of this year. I'm not going to say this right now. I'm going to say it at the very end when I talk last. But anyone else want to say?
I do, if people don't mind.
Go for it.
Sure.
So I feel two ways about it, from, you know, just my personal, how I feel about it, and everyone, you guys, personal friends, how they reacted to it. When we first, not when we got this message, but when we first saw the message, the Twitter post saying, oh, next week, which is now this week,
yeah,
you're going to get a message talking about future updates. I feel like even no
everyone
matter how
everyone thought it was going to be Mickey and Brooms.
Well, even if it was, it really depends. Okay, I think people would have been more upset if Square Enix would have been like, so guys, you're going to get Mickey and Brooms in 5 months.
Oh, yeah. No, I thought it was going to be like, Mickey and Brooms are coming at the end of this month. I never in my wildest dreams expected them to say, you're getting something in 5 months.
I wasn't expecting that either. But honestly, it was more of a, I think this shows, or hopefully it shows Square Enix, that no matter what they try and do, you're not going to make the majority of the people who played or play this game happy, considering.
Right.
Whether you tell them what's going to happen, what is happening straight to their face, there are people who are going to be outraged. There are people who are going to be like, it doesn't matter. Or there are going to be people who are like, I didn't need this because I'm still happy playing the game, but thanks, it doesn't make a difference. I'm still playing the game or not.
Right. You bring up a good point, actually. Would anything have made people happy?
Unless they would have said something like, congratulations, all of you who have continued playing. For every day you have logged in, here is 100 extra jewels. So you've been playing for 150 days. Here's 15,000 jewels. Go crazy, because it's still,
you
not, enough
get five
do,
pulls.
It's still not enough to do 10 pulls.
You can do five. You can't even get a guaranteed illustrated.
Yep.
Oh, wow. That's wow.
But you see, it's like, if you're already not in the mindset of, I'm going to enjoy this game no matter what happens, nothing's going to make
you
happy.
Well, who do you, okay, we haven't always been in that mindset, though, have we? I mean, I remember when we started playing this game.
Yeah. But also, the other mindset I have about this is, Square Enix we're and this is gonna sound bad to a lot of people, but no, I don't need to offend anybody. We are all a camel, and you're just putting more straw on our back until it breaks.
Well, if you've noticed, a lot of people stop playing.
Exactly. But what straw for what person, or what straw for what camel, I guess.
Yeah.
Right, right.
No, that's a very good, you actually brought up a really great point. Everyone at this point is so salty, and we're still playing. We're still, well, some of us, because a lot of, I got to tell you guys, again, if you haven't played PMQ, I suggest you try it, because there's a lot of people who have stopped playing and started playing PMQ. Because it's kind of funny to play a game where you actually feel good about playing it.
To quote DUJ, this is the most complicated dual relationship ever.
Yes. Yeah, it is. It is. It is. It's, man, it was, it's hard. But no. Anyway, okay. Before I say something, anyone else want to say anything?
All I'm saying is that, obviously we care a lot about this game if we've spent all this time and sometimes money into it, because we like it for, you know, mm-hmm. any number of reasons. Like, for me, I'm still really into the game because I'm interested in the story. I haven't looked into any spoilers, so I'm just taking it right. as it comes to me.
Oh, that's a whole other topic too, man.
Yeah, sure.
Gosh, yeah.
But for, I've put in a lot of money into this game, not into like 4 digits or anything, but still pretty well up there.
Mm-hmm.
And based on what I've given to the game, I think I've gotten just enough to where I'm happy with my experience. And I know that that's not how a lot of people are looking at it, and that sucks for them, because I think it really should be, Square needs to look at like this community and just understand that we really need more for, you know, for the free to players. We need better mm-hmm. polls for this. I know that's such a broad thing to say, but it really is that simple. If they make it so that we can get a little bit more out of this game, I think people are going to be happier for it, because I think the next 2 months are going to be very crucial as to whether or not people are going to be around to play that stuff in 5 months.
Right.
If you go through this little rough patch we're going to have, you'll be fine. But if not, I'd probably suggest playing something else, because it probably won't be getting a little better.
Do you think it's ever going to get really great? Really great?
I hope so, because if in 5 months that stuff they have planned out is really lackluster and it's underwhelming for a lot of people, that can kill the game.
Well, and this is something else that I want to talk about before we end too. That's okay. You know, and thank you very much to everyone on Discord. I'm going to close Discord off right now for a second. Thank you very much, everyone on Discord. Really, I really appreciate it. And you know what? We're probably going to do another one of these soon. Where I am going to open up Discord to everyone so everyone can talk and listen and you know, give their opinion. But this video's already gone really long. I gotta say, I see... I'm going to tell you guys what I saw when I saw that update. When I saw that update, or the future update they talked about... I thought two big things. I thought 5 more months of paying VIP every single day, every single week. And I thought 5 more months of Epic Metal Carnivals, High Score Challenges. And to be perfectly honest, I didn't think, 5 more months of story. 5 more months of new Keyblades, 5 more months of new metals. And I can't even think that, because any new metal that is introduced into this game is going to be behind a paywall. Unless they do even the challenge metals. Like, okay, let's think of it this way. If Mowgli and Baloo, or, you know, if they release metals like that, or... The earliest one we can relate the most to, the Queen of Hearts and Cards. how many of these quest medals or challenge, well, let's call them challenge medals. How many of these challenge medals are we getting every month? 2, 4? How do they stack and compare to the premium medals, epic medals, legendary medals? I can't, if I were to think, and I hate to say it, that's what I thought. That's what I thought when I looked at the update. 5 more months. Okay, and this is the thing too. When I saw the update, I was like, okay, so what was the 2 big things in the update? The new story or what? Oops, I lost a whale. That's what Scarina is saying right now, huh? There goes another one. Okay, main story content, Proud Quest, and the multiplayer. Okay, so in 5 months, we're going to get more story. So to story that's going to advance the Kingdom Hearts world plotline. Multiplayer mode, which sounds complicated to me. It sounds really complicated to me. And it sounds great to be able to help party members do things if they don't have the medals to do them with. And proud mode. And you know what? I'm not even going to touch proud mode because that's all I see when I see this is paywall. I mean, seriously, I'm not going to lie. When I look at this game and I saw that, I saw 5 more months of VIP, 5 more months of Epic Metal Carnivals, 5 more months of high score challenges. And I should have been seeing something else. I should have been seeing something more positive. I enjoy the game. I enjoy a lot of aspects of the game. I am very thankful for what I do have in the game. I have some amazing medals that can give me some amazing stuff to do. I'm still barely scratching the surface of what skills can do for you in this game. The capacity to do stuff is just, it's wow. It's amazing, guys. I gotta tell you guys, it is amazing the capacity that skills can give you in this game and what you can do in this game. I feel like spending the money has given me a hammer to smack on the wall that's in front of me in this game when I should have been thinking of a more creative way to get around the wall. And there is. We've seen this. There are people who are very intelligent in this game. They've gotten so far. We have in our Discord free-to-play players or players who have spent very minimum amount of money who have advanced just astronomically in this game, who have gotten incredible amounts of in our party even, you know? I mean, I gotta tell you guys, Duck McMuffin, Actkio, these are 3 free-to-play players who just walloped everyone else. When we did our own little party challenge of trying to see who got the most lux, they destroyed everyone else. All of our other party members, they just, dedication and love of a game can take you very far. Pretty much the last thing I'm going to say is the same thing I've been saying for a little while. With every new update that Square Enix is giving us in this game, with every new change that they've given us, quest medals being taken away from pulls, it feels weird that they've given us 3,000 jewels in the first week of this month. To me, when we've seen that, to me, I've taken a step back and been like, whoa, wait, what are you doing? It's kind of like, you know, when someone goes to give you a hug, but you're like, hey, what are you trying to do here? You know, because that person, it's like if you had a school, it's like if you had a bully at school, and I'm not laughing at bullies. Sorry. But it's like if you had a kid who torments you every single day, takes your bag, chases you around the yard, throws stuff at you. And all of a sudden, one day, they come up and give you a hug. You'd be like, whoa, 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 wait, what are you trying to do to me? You know? It would. You'd be kind of like, hey, 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 you know what? What are you, back off, you know? and I hate to say it, guys, but that's how I feel. That's how I feel with this game. That's how I feel with them giving these 3,000 free jewels at the first week of the of this month. I kind of feel like, whoa, 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 wait, what are you doing? Why are you giving me this? Because we've gotten so used to be treated a certain way, and I'm talking free to play players and pay to play players. You know, the pay to play players can feel slightly different too, because after all the hundreds of dollars you can spend and all the money you can spend trying to get a medal or trying to do something and then not really advancing at all, it's like the whole iceberg metaphor, you know? You go one step forward, but you actually go back three steps. I've constantly said, too little, too late. This update made me feel like it's even if they were to release this tomorrow, this new story, this multiplayer mode, these proud quests, even if this had said coming in October, it's too little, too late. The damage has been done. And I have to say this, and this goes out to Square Enix. So this is pretty much Dear Square Enix number two. Dear Square Enix, the damage has been done and people are leaving. And yes, new people are finding the game. Good for you. Good for your game. Good for your bottom line. Good for your money. Because there are new people coming to this game every single day. And I will honestly say, I hope that they enjoy the game. I hope that they follow Lou's advice. I hope that they try and play this game like that. Because Square Enix, you're losing a lot of players who stuck with you from day one. You're losing a lot of people who, and I'm not going to say names, guys, or anything. And I'm sure some of the people would be more than happy to come in and say, you know, what they feel. But you're losing a lot of people, Square Enix, who have stayed with your game from day one, spent a lot of money, believed in it, tried the game, tried to push into the game, and they're at a point where they don't want to feel the way they feel anymore. They feel hurt. They feel like they gave you all this money and you didn't appreciate it. And you're losing a lot of players like that. You're losing a lot of players who have invested a lot of money into your game and you're acting like you don't care that they're leaving either. And that's the hardest part about this. Because even if you were to release free jewels tomorrow, and actually what Nelson said was actually a really good idea. If you've been playing this game for this long and logged in every day, you're going to get more. That's actually a really great idea of compensating people. Because even if tomorrow or next week you release, you know, free jewel quest, or you start, or even if from now on every single week is going to be like this, and for apparently no reason you're just going to be giving us 1,000, 2,000, 3,000 jewels a week, it's too late. It's too late because there's people who have been playing for over 150 days and they've given you thousands of dollars of their hard-earned money, and they're going to sit back and be like, okay, so you're treating all these new players really great and they feel wonderful because they feel loved, and they feel so great, you know. because you are giving them all this love and attention, and it's a great game, but the people who helped your game become what it is, the people who started playing every single day, and I'm going to count myself in that group, because Square Enix, I was playing this game at 2 in the morning on April 7th, and the videos are on YouTube. I downloaded this game in the first 20 minutes they came out. I played for 18 hours the very first day it came out. I fell in love with this game from the very beginning of it, and exploring it and discovering what the metal system does, and how the keyblades worked and everything. It was so exciting and so great. And there are tens of thousands, if not more, of people out there who went through the exact same experience from the very beginning, from day one of this game. The people who helped your game, the first 100,000 downloads and everything, all those people who invested tons of time and a lot of money into making your game what it is now, Square Enix. You're losing those people. And changing things in the game now in the future, or throwing a bunch of jewels, or giving away a bunch of free stuff, it doesn't make those people feel any better. Because they help make your game what it is, and you know what, you don't owe them anything. You really don't. It's a business. Your game is a business. You do what you want with your game, and you know what, you can take all the money that those people did and you can just be happy with it and work towards making the future people feel good. But I hope you understand that a lot of people don't feel good. And it's too late for a lot of them. No matter what you're going to do, it's a lot of people are just not. Anyway, sorry. It got off track there a little bit. Thank you for watching, guys. Thank you for supporting. Thank you for being here. And as I said before, I'm not stopping playing this game. I love Kingdom Hearts. I love the concept. I love my Moogle feathery butt outfit. I love it. Okay, I love my setups. I love some of the changes in this game. And I know this has been not a suit, you know, we haven't been just highlighting all the others. Guys, I love the stacking system. I love the new Keyblade system. I'm barely beginning to explore that. There's a lot of this stuff in this game that I absolutely love. So I'm going to keep playing the game. And I'm going to keep doing what I can. But the one thing I'm also going to do, and I promise you guys this, is I'm not going to forget. And you know what? There's a lot of people who watch my stream and watch my YouTube who are playing Puzzle Monsters Quest now. And they stopped playing Kingdom Hearts. And they're playing other games. There's a lot of people playing other games. And guys, there's some really great console, PC, and mobile games coming out in the next few months. And I'm going to continue playing this game until people don't want to see any more of it. Because that's what I do. So thank you for watching, guys. Thank you for supporting. If you guys are here for Kingdom Hearts Unchained content, believe me, there's a lot more to come. If you're here for other content too, believe me, there's lots more of that to come too. But thank you. Thank you for watching. And that's for me. Thank you for watching. Thank you for supporting. Thank you for being with me. I totally 100% less than three, every single one of you. Thank you guys. And I'll see you guys next time. See ya.